Hello guys and welcome back to my channel. So guys, in this video we'll be studying about benzoin condensation reaction. So guys, in this reaction what we usually do is that we take a benzaldehyde. Okay, so let us draw a benzaldehyde. So this is your normal benzaldehyde. We take this benzaldehyde and we convert it into a compound known as benzoin, hence the name benzoin condensation reaction. Now what we actually do is that we take 2 moles of this benzaldehyde and we use a cyanide ion, okay, in this reaction. And this cyanide ion has a significance that why do we use cyanide ion, so which we are going to be discussing in a minute. So this both reacts together to form a compound known as benzoin. So how does benzoin look like? This is the compound which is known as benzoin. So we'd be studying how we use a benzaldehyde to form a benzoin compound. So we'll be studying this via mechanism. So what actually happens is that we took 2 moles here. That means in mechanism first we are going to be starting with 1 mole of this thing. 1 mole of benzaldehyde. I took one part of this compound and then we added into it cyanide ion. So after adding the cyanide ion, what would be happening is that the cyanide ion would be reacting with the electropositive center of carbon. So it would be formed, and this of course would be changing in the electron density. So O would get a negative charge here with a H here and cyanide attached to carbon. Now there is another stage. That means what actually happens after this is that there is a shift of this negative charge here. Okay. And what actually happens is that this H transferred here, and here we have CN with a negative charge, and this carbon is now having a negative charge. So we call this kind of carbons as carbon ion. So there is a formation of a carbon ion. Now after the formation of carbon ion, there is another step in which we have used 1 mole here. We are left with another mole which we use here in this step. Now we add the benzaldehyde, 1 mole of benzaldehyde in this step. Now what actually happens is that we have this thing. Now it would get attached to the carbon with the negative charge. We already have this here. Okay. Now this carbon would be, now what actually happens is that here is a change in the electron density, so this would get a negative charge of course. Okay, so we'd be getting a oxygen with a negative charge with the phenyl here and H here. Okay, so now in order to satisfy this negative charge, this hydrogen of this OH would be shifted here. Okay, and then what do we get? PH, C, single bond O with a negative charge, and there's the C, OH, okay, CH, OH, PH. This is what you would be having. Okay, now in order to, and we have a cyanide here as well. So now this negative charge transfers the density here to form a double bond, and as a result the cyanide goes off. So what do we get is, the remaining thing that we get is, sorry for the focus, PH, C double bond O, CH, OH, PH, and this is our benzoin. Okay, so this is the final product, which is benzoin, which is formed. So this is the whole mechanism for benzoin condensation reaction. I hope you guys like this video. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. As this is a new channel, please help us to grow. Thank you so much, and subscribe us for more videos. Have a very nice day.